Okay, now see here. I'll redraw this part again, once again. So take your X, Y, V, P, H, P. This Y. Tetrahedron means, as I said, it's a triangular pyramid. Tetra means four. Hedron means equal faces. So it is four equal faces. If you see in the question bank, sorry, if you see here in the question bank, you can see this problem of 36. A tetrahedron of 55 mm sides resting on one of its corner, such that edge containing the corner is inclined to HP at 50 degree and to VP at 30 degree. So based on that, let us solve the problem. Okay, tetrahedron 55 mm sides resting on one of its corner of its base on HP, such that edge containing the corner is inclined 50 degree to HP and to VP at 30 degree. So now here, 55 mm sides triangle, 55 angle 0, 55 angle 120, 55 angle minus 120. Okay, get the midpoint of the triangle. How do I get it? Opposite edge midpoint, corner, opposite edge midpoint, corner, opposite edge midpoint. So like this, and trim the unwanted thing, like this one, and this one. So I've got a tetrahedron, triangle portion. Set the entire thing, since it is resting on one of its corner, top tip as first click, bottom edge midpoint as second click, rotate it till it gets a corner condition. Let's move it down and name the corners. Here, there's a point A, this is the point B, this is the point C, this is O bracket O1. Okay, now draw projection line from each and every corner, 0.05 line thickness. Okay, so from BC till XY line, from O1 till XY line, and further extend it. How much? I don't know. Okay, then from here till X1. Now, what is the procedure of getting the tetrahedron front view? Here, axis length will not be given in the question. Tetrahedron of 55 mm sides or tetrahedron of 40 mm sides will be the question. So, in this case, what we are supposed to do, we have to observe where is the corner of the triangle. Here, since it is a corner condition, I have got the corner on the right side. Suppose if it is a edge condition, I'll get the corner on the left side. Okay. So first, let us see problem number 36 now. Here, it's a corner condition. I've got the corner on the right side. So corner end projection line from here, you have to cut an arc of the triangle dimension. Okay. So what is the dimension of the triangle? I've given it as 55 mm. So your arc should be of radius 55 mm. From where? From corner end projection line. From here, at a radius of 55, you have to cut an arc on the axis line. So from here, like this. So this should be the arc. I am not interested to know what is this length. I am not interested to know what is the axis length got. Okay. But from corner end projection line, the arc length should be. From corner end projection line, the arc length should be the triangle dimension. Now from here, one click. Let us create the base. Second click. Third click. Arc end point over here. Okay. And since this is axis line, in the line style two, third one, axis lines. As extra portion is not required, let us trim this off. And here I'm showing you this has to be 55. Okay. So name the corner. This is the point B dash of C dash. Next is O1 dash. And last is A dash. Okay. This is A dash. And over here we have O dash. Okay, now he says edge, please observe, he says edge containing the corner is inclined 50 degree to HP. Okay, which is the edge containing the corner? Edge has two corners, one at the starting, the other one at the ending. Okay, whereas this, if you see, if you say, sir, this is the edge containing the corner, I'm sorry, this is not the edge containing the corner, because this edge has three corners, corner A, corner B, and corner C. So this is not the edge containing the corner, this is the base, triangle base, base containing the corner. So this cannot be edge containing the corner. So this is the edge containing the corner, because edge has two corners, one at the starting, the other one at the ending. So O, A are the only two corners for this edge. Whereas here, A, B, C, there are three corners. So three corners are nothing but it's a triangle. Okay. So this is inclined to an angle 50 degrees. So select the entire thing, go to move command, switch on the copy option. This endpoint, take it in the second position here. Okay. Now going to rotate command, please observe earlier and all we had axis inclined to HP 40, 50 degree like that. So when axis was inclined 50 degree, base was 90 minus 50, that is 40 degree. That is how we are supposed to do it. Whereas now axis is not inclined, it is the edge inclined. This edge inclination will not be, we cannot do base as 90 minus that angle. We have to give inclination for this inclined edge itself. So if you see here, in rotation angle, it is 0 degree. In the ribbon bar, you see, rotation angle, it is 0 degree. Position angle is 125.6 degree. Actually, with respect to XY line, your OA is inclined 125.6. This 125.6 should become 50 degree. So if you see, when I take it to XY line, it becomes 0 degree. So that position angle you should give, not the rotation angle. In this problem, it give position angle. So 50. So this is what the inclination is. If you want, please check the angle between this edge line and XY line. It is 50 degree. So this is correct. Okay. So please be careful when you're doing this problem. Projection line 0.05. Draw projection line from each and every corner. From BC. I'll move it overall. From BC. At C point. And at P point. Then O1. From O1, it is in the center. From A, again, A is also center. Then from O, O is also in the center. Now draw projection line horizontally. C will stop here. Stop here. O1, O and A. O1, A and O. Right? And B point will stop here. Right? Now name the corners. For your understanding, this is your point A, this is the point B, this is the point C, this is the point O1, and this is the point O. Outermost boundary line dark. Line command, 0.5 thickness, outermost boundary line dark, that is B to O, O to C, and C to A line, A point, very close to XY line, so this portion should be drawn dotted. So from where to where? Since A point is very close to XY line, B to A should be dotted, A to C also should be dotted, then O to A also it should be dotted. Okay. O to A, O to B and O to C is already done, so no need to worry. Whereas O to A is the line that you are supposed to check. Okay. So let us make this axis line. This has axis line, O to O1 axis line, chain line. Okay. Now, what is the third stage? The same edge is inclined 30 degree to which edge? Edge containing the corner. That is nothing but OA itself. OA itself is inclined 30 degree to V. If you see in the first stage, OA dimension is 55. How about it in the second stage? OA dimension, this dimension is 35.35. Okay. Since there is change in dimension, we have to solve using beta angle. So reduce the line's thickness to 0.05. Draw a line inclined to an angle 30 degree. Minus 30, enter, draw this line, go to arc by center point method, anywhere from the line, this dimension should be 55, cut an arc, okay, then locus line, from here, draw an horizontal line, second arc will be 35.35, go to the arc which I already cut, it'll show you the starting point from here, type 35.35, enter. This arc is over here. Then from line, using line command, draw a line here. From this arc to the starting point and further back, extend it till XY line. This line extended back till XY line. And please measure the angle. It will be, how much you please check it. It will be 51 degree. Okay. Then select the entire thing. Go to move command, switch on the copy option, go point, go to the arc which I already cut, starting point of the arc, right click, then you rotate command, top tip as first click, opposite edge midpoint a second click, put it on the mid angle line. So this is how you get it. Now go back to line command, continuous line, 0.05 line thickness, draw projection line from each and every corner. This is a point O. You move your overhaul. So this is a point O, right? Then A point on XY line, B point, B point is over here, C point also over there only, then O1 point till here. Okay, draw horizontal lines. This is the O line up to here, BC, C point over here, B point over here, O1 point over here, A point, anyway, it's on the line, so no need to worry. Go back to text command. This is your point A dash. This is your point B dash. This is your point C dash, O dash, and O1 dash. And O1 dash. Okay. Draw outermost boundary line dark fast. So 0.5 thickness, continuous line. A to B, B to C, C to O, O to back A. Now AC is the line which you are supposed to touch. AC, if you see, it is far away from XY line. Okay, so A to C should be a dotted line, a dark line. Then O to B, B is a point over here. B is very, very close to XY line compared to your A point and C point. You can see A point is on the locus line, whereas B point is inside locus line. So B point is very close to XY line. So O to B, it should be a dotted line. So change the line style to dotted. Draw this line, and O to O1, it is chain line, axis line style. So change the line style to a chain. So any more doubts? This is what you are supposed to do it in the tetrahedron problem. This is problem number 36. Hope this is clear. Okay, I'll stop the recording now.